everybody, it's Abby. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome if you're new. We've made it to the end of 2020, so today I'm going to be showing you my favorites for the year. And this is actually the first time I've ever done a end of year favorites video. I just kind of forget, and it's hard for me to remember what I've got in a year and what I got like a long time ago. So I used to have a makeup inventory thing like on a Google Sheets document, and I kind of didn't keep up with it for a while, but I've reignited it, or restarted it, I guess, and I have everything that I own listed on there and when I got it. So all I had to do was look at the things that I bought in 2020, and I went from there. This year I've tried a lot of new brands and a lot of new products, and a lot of products that I wouldn't normally try, I don't think. So I am really excited to share my favorites for the year. Some of the stuff I can't believe was this year, like a lot of things that have happened in like first half of the year, I'm like, that seems like forever ago. First up for face products, the best foundation that I have tried this year. I actually tried a few. I was surprised at how many that I tried this year. But my favorite is the NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Full Coverage Foundation. So like it says, it is full coverage, and this shade is perfect for me. I have the shade 03 Porcelain, and this is great if you have oily skin. If you have like dry skin, it may not work for you. So it's kind of not the best for me at the moment in the winter, where my skin is all flaky and scaly. But during the summer, this is great. Could probably use it now if I exfoliated and, you know, did my skincare. Well, I don't ever skip skincare, but sometimes I don't do as good of a job as I should. If you're looking for a new foundation, I have a whole list on my blog of cruelty-free and vegan foundations that are $16 or less. And I have a chart in there that will show you which one will be the best for your skin type and also your level of coverage. All right, then for concealer, I have the Uma Stay Woke Concealer. This is a new brand to me. I've tried a few things from them. I think almost everything that they have that's vegan I've tried so far, except I think they have like an eyeliner and something else that I haven't tried yet. But this concealer is really good. It's really full coverage, and it a little tiny bit goes a long way with this one. The only thing I don't know about is the shade. This is White Pearl T0.5, and this one is not on their website. I got this on Ulta, and it's been sold out on Ulta, so I don't know if they're not making this shade anymore. It's just a hair too light for me, but I like that for under my eyes. I was surprised because it's rare for me to find a face product that's too light for me. And then for blush, I really have been liking these e.l.f. bite-sized face duos. So I don't use the highlighter. It doesn't really do anything for me. It's too dark. So I just use the blushes. I have on this one today in pomegranate, if you can tell. This other one that I have is white peach. And these are really good. They're only like $3, I think. So even though I'm not using the highlighter, I don't feel so bad about only spending $3 on the other half. And I like that they are matte. You could top them with the highlighter instead of using that as just a highlighter if you didn't want the blush to be matte. Best highlighter that I've tried this year is the Milani Supercharged. Well, it's the highlighter duo, and the name is Supercharged. They have a few different shades of this. And this one has a cream and a powder highlight, and I can never get it open. So I mostly use this one. It's the cream, and I have that on today as well. And then this one is a powder. It's a little more intense, you can tell in the pan it's pink. So I have to be careful with that one. Use it very sparingly. This is one of the best highlighters that I have found at the drugstore. Then this was an unexpected favorite. I usually don't go for things like this, and I honestly don't remember to use it as much as I should. But it is the Uma Double Take Sculpt and Strobe Duo Stick, and I have the shade White Pearl. It has this contour on one side, which is the perfect shade for me, and then also this highlighter on the other side, which is a very beautiful natural highlighter. I just always forget to use it. A cream product like that you would want to put on before you set anything with powder, and I always forget until after I set with powder. Now onto eyes. So normally most eyeshadow primers are kind of the same to me, but this one came out this year, I think this year, maybe the end of last year, and it has like changed everything. This is the KVD Vegan Beauty Shake Primer. I have a whole review video dedicated to this, and I compare it to another eyeshadow primer. This is just amazing. Like, if you have an eyeshadow that's kind of meh, like, this will make it good. Next favorite for eyes. I clearly have a problem with these e.l.f. liquid glitter eyeshadows. So these are amazing. Like, I don't know. I have a whole video about these as well. And you can use these like all over your lid as like a one shadow kind of deal. You can put it on like your eyelid part for a a little bit more shine. You can put it underneath of your lower lash line. Again, I have a whole video about different ways to use these, but I absolutely love them. And if you're looking for any kind of like a liquid glitter or like a liquid eyeshadow kind of thing, I would definitely recommend these. Because there are more expensive versions of these, and these are just as good, if not better. A new brow product that I discovered this year. I don't remember when this one came out, but I did get it this year. It is the Urban Decay Inked Brow. So I occasionally will do like craft shows for my business, and this year we obviously had to wear masks. So my problem with makeup when I wear a mask is if I'm taking it on and off, I have to like move my glasses up or totally take them off to put my mask back over my nose. And while I was doing this with my glasses, it was rubbing off my eyebrows right here in the middle, and my eyebrows look like they started here. So I got this because it is waterproof and like transfer resistant, and it really helped and did not budge throughout the day. The only thing is it's kind of drying out. I do have a whole video about this one as well, but it's kind of drying out at this point. But I think there's not much product in it, so maybe I'll store it like this. That way it'll be easier to get on the little brush. This one is a game changer as well, also from KVD Beacon Beauty. It's the Epic Curl Lash Primer. I have a whole, I don't know if I did a video about this, but I did a whole blog post about the Epic Curl Lash Primer. And if your eyelashes are like mine, where no matter what you do, no matter how hard you curl them or what kind of mascara you use, they just point straight down, this is what you need. I've always kind of felt that lash primer was kind of gimmicky and didn't really do anything, but this actually works and it is amazing. My favorite eyeshadow palette of the year has to be the Slush palette from September Rose Cosmetics. I believe I did a 3 looks 1 palette with this one as well, and I did several Halloween looks with it. This is just an amazing sort of rainbow but not really palette. Like, it's kind of got that rainbow order, but there's no like Roy G. Biv in there, you know. It's kind of like a variations of the colors. And I already have a few dips, especially in like this lemon and lime color. I really, really like that shade, and it does show up like as bright as it is in the pan, if not brighter, with that shake primer. And these reds down here were amazing as well. I use those for quite a few Halloween looks. Quite a few new lip products this year as well that I really, really liked. So I was shocked by this one. So I have always hated, well, not always. At first I liked lip gloss, but then I started hating it in favor of matte liquid lipsticks. And then now I'm like, my lips are so dry and they're just awful. So I needed something that would help with that. And like matte liquid lipstick just wasn't working because they were so peely. And I found these KVD Vegan Beauty Exo Vinyl lip creams, and these are amazing. They are kind of like a lip gloss, but also more of like a lipstick. So they're not like they feel like a lip balm on your lips instead of a gloss, which I didn't like because I feel like gloss just kind of like seeps its way into your mouth. Ugh. But I tried this one first. They had a set with a mini of the Lolita shade in that, plus a mini of the Lolita liquid lipstick. So I got that one. I really liked this formula. And then I ordered these two in the full size. So this one is the shade Blossom, and then the one I'm wearing today is the shade Carnation. And I thought, before I got these, I was like, oh, I wish that they would come out with a mini set of these because I would get them all. And then I bought these two because they were on sale, and then like right after that, like not even 2 or 3 days after I ordered those, they came out with a mini set for the holiday. I was like, well, that's a bummer. But I know for sure I'll get good use out of these because they're the only product that will work if my lips are crusty. I did discover a liquid lipstick type product as well. These are the Lime Crime Plushies, and I have this shade called Cola and this one called Butterscotch. And these are really sheer liquid lipsticks. So if you have liquid lipsticks that are really thick and kind of can kind of get sticky and also like crackly, these will not do that. They are really a sheer formula. I really like these. They have a lot of different colors as well. I think these just make your lips look better as well. You could even try to find like a My Lips But Better kind of shade. So these last lip products came in toward the end of the year and they really surprised me. So these are the e.l.f. Seriously Satin lipsticks. I usually, if I go for a bullet style lipstick like this, I will go for a matte one. But I was like, oh, I'll just give these a try because again, my crusty lips, I needed something that wasn't super matte because matte formulas can really make that worse. So I tried these out and they are just as good as like other high-end lipsticks that I've tried. And they're like, what, $3 or $4? I have the shade Persimmon, Nectar and Sugar Plum. And Nectar is a really nice nude shade for me. Sugar Plum is kind of iffy, like I might need a lip liner with that one because it's really bold. It's also kind of interesting to see like how much lipstick is down in the packaging, because when you use up a lipstick, you think that it stops like right underneath that line, but it does not. Like this, there's that much left by the time you use it down to like the nub. So a lot of wasted product in lipsticks, but I mean, what else, like, how else should they do that? Because if they only put it up to there, then it's going to just fall out. So yeah, I don't know. I tried to use everything that I could on my face today for these. I am trying to finish up some things for my project pan, and I think the finale for that will be my next video, if not the one after. So let me know if any of these were your favorites as well, if you've tried any of them, or if you have other favorites from the year. So stay tuned for my project pan update, and I'm also going to do another empties video soon. So click up here to watch my most recent video, or click up here to watch another video that I think you might like. And give this video a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss seeing my face in your subscription box every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. The links to all these products and my social media, my business, and my blog will be in the description box below, and I will see you guys in the comments. Bye.